Point of order, Madam Fox.
Mr. Speaker, I seek leave for the House to adjourn at 10 PM tonight or at the conclusion of members' order of the day number 5, whichever is earlier. And the reason being that there literally will be about 10 to 15 minutes, possibly, in which I'll be introducing my bill, but then we may not get another opportunity to debate that bill until next year following the Christmas break. So I would prefer that it was done all together.
Leave is put for that purpose. Is there any objection? There appears to be none. I call Clayton Mitchell.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise on behalf of New Zealand First to speak to this bill put in front of us today, the Births, Deaths and Marriages and Relationship Registration, Preventing Name Change by Child Sex Offenders Amendment Bill, and that is a mouthful that I'll just narrow that down to, the Name Changing of Child Sex Offenders Amendment Bill for the rest of this speech. Mr. Speaker, this is a very, very serious matter and one that New Zealand First takes extremely seriously, as do all New Zealanders when it talks about our young children, the vulnerable people in our society and those people perpetrating crimes against them along the lines of sexual activity of that nature. We do support this bill moving forward, and we do get behind what Dr. Jiang Jiang is saying here. However, notwithstanding that, there are a number of holes. This legislation is very, very wide that you could drive a bus through, but we see the right place to get down to the nuts and bolts of this piece of legislation is in the select committee process. And we would like to hear from submitters, people in the community that have a deep understanding of this situation, to try and iron out some of those issues. Mr. Speaker, we have read the Attorney-General's report, and like many Attorney-General reports, they don't always support the legislation that's put forward by government or some other private members' bills, but you have to be objective and look at that and say, where can we straighten this piece of legislation up in? Some of the unintended consequences, I think, really come down to a situation that encapsulates other crimes committed, and largely those crimes should be collected. Murderers, assault with intent to rob, etc. And then, of course, you've got indecent assaults. Or we do have a situation where there is people captured under the Film, Videos and Publications Classifications Act relating to publications of objectionable material. Now, I could think of a number of scenarios where you might have a female in a situation that she's got herself on the minor end of an indecent assault or somehow involved negatively in Publications Act, that finds herself on that sex offenders register. Now, in a situation where she decides in time to come to get married, and the name change of changing it to her husband's name will pose as what I would consider an unintended consequence. But I believe the right place to iron out these unintended consequences are, of course, in select committee. And I think the Attorney-General's report is a very good, in-depth and thorough report delving into some of those holes, but I would much rather err on the side of caution, and New Zealand First would much rather be supporting this bill because it's a step in the right direction as opposed to not taking that step at all. And it does dovetail in quite nicely to the Sex Offenders Register, which is very, very topical at the moment, Mr. Speaker. And New Zealand First, of course, does support legislation that does come down hard on the criminals in our society, those criminals that are perpetrating crimes against other vulnerable New Zealand citizens. I did, however, take some offence to some of the words that Adrian Rafferty was talking about, and I think a lot of New Zealanders will take offence when we come to the Treaty of Waitangi and the rights of the Treaty of Waitangi, because to me that's offensive that somehow that the Treaty of Waitangi protects those.
Sorry to have to interrupt the member, but the time has come for the dinner adjournment. The House is adjourned until 7:30.